Hey boss, I wanted to pop in real quick because a lot of changes are happening regarding the vaccine mandate and what this means to your small business. So this episode, this video is really going to talk about that. And this is the latest changes that are happening that you as a business owner with 100 or more employees should be aware of. And this will help you with your decisions regarding your employees. Hey, I'm Dr. Heather Williamson with the Transformation Group. And welcome back to the channel. So if you don't want to miss out on any of leadership tips and strategies that I share on a weekly basis, then subscribe to this channel because a lot of stuff is coming out and a lot of things are happening that you should be aware of as a leader of your organization. So let's get started. So I actually found this information yesterday and today, and this is the latest updates regarding the vaccine mandate and what the suspended vaccine mandate means to your private business. So yesterday, a multi-circuit lottery was expected to be held, and the purpose is to determine the fate of the Biden administration's vaccine mandate issued by the Occupational Safety and Health Administration, obviously, which is OSHA. And actually, this was set as when it was set a January 4th deadline for estimated number of 84 million private sector workers to be vaccinated against the COVID-19 or be tested weekly and wear a mask. And there are financial fines for those businesses that do not follow this mandate. And so at least 27 states, as well as private employers, religious organizations, and other groups have filed lawsuits against the administration's mandate, claiming that it exceeds its authority in issuing the mandate. And as a result, there are now OSHA-related lawsuits pending in 12 different court of appeals. And the lottery is being utilized this week, which actually came out yesterday, of all the different courts that are now circuit courts that are going to be actually listening to this. But it's part of a federal law that is why this is happening. And under the law, multiple changes or challenges to the OSHA rule that have been filed in separate courts will be consolidated in a single court of appeals and selected at random. And like I said, this happened Tuesday, yesterday, and then what came out today, which I think is really important for you to understand and know, is that the OSHA suspended the enforcement of the Biden administration's COVID-19 vaccine mandate for all private businesses. So those with 100 employees or more, it has now been suspended. The announcement came shortly after a U.S. appeals court rejected a challenge by the Biden administration on November 12th and affirmed its decision to put on hold OSHA's mandate, which requires that, like I said, the businesses with 100 or more employees or more that ensure workers either be vaccinated against COVID-19 by January 4th or be tested and wear a mask. So the Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals in New Orleans stated in an opinion that OSHA's mandate is staggeringly overbroad and ordered it to take no steps to implement or enforce the mandate until further court order. The court had previously issued a temporary halt to the mandate on November 6, pending litigation, and I had shared that in a previous video. So I quote, "The court ordered that OSHA take no steps to implement or enforce the ETS until further court order. While OSHA remains confident in its authority to protect workers in emergency, OSHA has suspended activities related to the implementation and enforcement of the ETS pending further developments in the litigation." The Labor Department affirmed in a statement in recognition of the court's ruling. So again, at least 27 U.S. states, as well as private employers, religious organizations, and other groups have sued the Biden administration, claiming that it exceeds its authority in issuing the mandate. So this is the latest, and I think that this information should let you know that you don't have to do anything at this time. Just have your businesses, you know, run as normal, have your employees, if they choose to get vaccinated, then that's fine, but it is no longer a mandate. It has been suspended at this time. So I know that the Biden administration is going to still push it, but they have no legal authority to do that. And another fact that I found out recently, and it kind of explains why all of this push towards everybody getting the vaccine, which is actually not a vaccine because it doesn't prevent you from getting it, it's more of a therapeutic, is that Pfizer, BioNTech, Moderna are making $1,000 every second from the COVID vaccine. And this is actually coming from the People's Vaccine Alliance. So it's very interesting what's happening, but I think it's great information for you as a business owner to be able to figure out what it is that you want to do and to know where things stand with regard to lawsuits and what is expected of you. So hopefully this helps. I will keep you updated as I see things coming across. And so don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on any more videos like this or other ones that actually are great leadership tips and strategies for you as a leader in your organization. And until next time, bye.